My name is Philip Meisel. The original name was Folk, actually. I was born in 1922, so my age is 92. I was working in the Holocaust Centre for the last 24 years. For the 22 years, I'm in charge of the Holocaust Testimonies Project. We collect the testimonies from the Holocaust survivors, first generation and second generation. In our collections, we have about 1,300 of testimonies, video testimonies, and 200 audio testimonies. All the interviewing are done here on the spot for two reasons. First, because we have a studio where we can control the light. Second thing, when people come to the Holocaust Center, they isolate themselves from the daily life. It's easier to bring them back into the past so they can concentrate on the events of the past and concentrate more on the subjects they're talking about.
I always felt that it was always so worthwhile and so valuable to the students, their learning and their understanding of the Holocaust, but it always went further and it was never just an excursion.
I think it's vital that the Jewish Holocaust Centre in Elsternwick is supported and is healthy, because it provides an invaluable service for Melburnians and Victorians and anyone visiting Melbourne, for that matter, tourists as well.
And the collection's a very rich resource. You know, it's not just a study of the Holocaust, it's a study of the passage of this material from, you know, Europe into Australia. It's the story of how people hold it for decades sometimes, you know, sometimes intergenerationally. And for my students, that's a very, very strong story about the value of cultural material. And it means it's a very strong story about the value of conservation. Our students go out to JHC and they walk around and they see things in context, and then they go up and see the archive, this beautifully maintained archive. And they get a real sense of what it means in a community collection to hold something dear, to hold it personally, and then to hand it over to a collection with the knowledge that that object is going to be looked after.
I'm Jane Joseph, curator at the Jewish Holocaust Centre, and we have an archive here that contains many significant items from the Melbourne survivors who were integral to the creation of the centre 30 years ago. To know that their stories are being carried on into the future, that their memories will be a permanent central part of this institution for decades to come. There are some survivors who were involved in the early days who've now passed away. Also, we have many survivors still active in the centre. We've also got younger volunteers, children or grandchildren of survivors who've come to the centre and feel connected to this centre. That's the reason they volunteer here at the Holocaust Centre, because of their connection to the past.
That was in 1937. Right. I was 11 years old at that time. It was my sister's engagement party. And they are all aunties, uncles, and cousins. Mm. And from all that group, only I survived, and one uncle that escaped to Russia. All the others were murdered. I won't be here for long. I am nearly 89. So how long can I be here? So at least somebody will tell my story.